Today I'm going to show how I replaced the fan on my ELSA RX 5700. Whilst awaiting their arrival, I watched some teardowns and identified the same cooling solution on an XFX RX 5700 XT60. Here's a screenshot from that teardown. The PCB differs near the PCIe connectors. I wasn't going to be attempting to flash BIOS from this card. If you can locate the video by the channel's background, then it's worth watching because he describes the legacy of the cooling solution here. All I needed to know was that the XFX TIC2 was a fit for my card, but I knew that already. What I didn't know, and still don't, was how it hid its wiring. I had just two measurements, 95mm and 39mm. Here's what I ordered, new two-piece set of 95mm fans. The title and description are clear that this is a fan for an RX 580 of some variety, but it was the nearest match I could get given the information at the time. Wires look way short, but physically it was a fit, and delivery was just 15 days if I could get my order to £8. I tried searching for this part number, which I read off the back of my fan. Nothing returned here would fit my shroud. Most of the other fans are for the Ultra Thick too, but the mounting holes are wrong. I can forget about using replacements from the RX 580 series, all the pictures of those are much shorter cards. The fans arrived last week, I'm happy with them. My GPU's been out of service for a few days, as I removed the cable tied fan from it in anticipation of these fans arriving. I just need to tear it down once more. One of the smaller screws doesn't go very deeply into the heatsink, less than a full turn. I was worried in the original video, but I can see that it came like that. A longer screw or some threadlock would be reassuring, but gravity is on my side in this case. Here are the wires in place as originally provided. I trust yours still are. If not, there's my previous video. With the fans in place, I can see the 39mm measurement was correct. Many adverts offered 40mm, and that sounded more convenient. The fans are in place, and before screwing them or lengthening their wiring, I'm attempting a couple of rotations to see how the cable might fit. Short cable is preferable, and solder and heat shrink would add bulk, reducing my opportunities to use the limited cable clips. I don't want to damage them. Like I was saying, gravity is on my side once this is in my case. The rearmost fan near the fan's wiring connector can be secured. There's no other orientation for it that could compensate for the drastically shorter cable of the new fan. The next fan is under pressure from the already clipped in wiring. I'm going to see if I can get one screw in, and then it will just need some simple rotation to fit the other two. The simple rotation was against the force of the wire. It was more force than the single screw could handle, and it popped out along with the plastic threads. I measured these screws before, they were all 2mm. I sped that up because that got a bit tedious. I didn't think anyone would need them, but now I could do with a bigger screw to replace the strip threads. So I'm not even sure if the fan screws were 2mm. It doesn't matter because I don't have any spare 2mm or similar size screws to upsize to. I don't want the hole in the shroud getting bigger. Half an hour later, and £1.25 poorer, I've got some new epoxy. Nice that it's got temperature ratings on the back. Can ask for more. This is strong stuff. It'll hold bolts and walls. I just need it to replace the strip threads. The epoxy has no grab, and I was going to use a cable tie, but it is curing too fast. And actually, this twisty wire is thinner and neater. Sets in 5 minutes. The wire tie is an impediment. I've got to think about breaking it out, maybe as soon as all the screws are in. Having looked at the card side on, there's a gap of a millimeter or two between the mating faces it's secured. There's this gap, even where the screws are still in place and fastening. It made me think that the screws aren't very strong at securing the fan to the shroud. They can't even bend this weak, thin plastic. And epoxy secures bolts and walls. It will fill gaps, just not 2mm ones, as this sits proud of the hole. It's going off fast, and it was viscous to begin with. I disconnected the fan connector because it was more than the last screw could handle. I dropped the original screw in the epoxy, figuring it will reinforce the plastic. Maybe even fused with the epoxy in the hole. I don't think the epoxy went in the hole. it's curing already and I don't feel it's fusing, so I decided to build up the one with more epoxy. This is impressively strong and fast. 25 minutes after first applying epoxy, I can connect the fan wiring again. Never letting the perfect be the enemy of the good, I've bent the softer, less insulated area and used just two of the five clips. I'd have liked to have got the epoxy all around, like a hard rubber band, but it needn't be super strong. Fillets and sandwiches will suffice. I installed it like this, but the failed screw was biting nothing. I could twist it freely in either direction. It wouldn't come out, so I may have mated with a ball of glue on the other side in the middle. I pulled the card later and dolloped glue over the screw, lest it fall into the fan and create a short. I secured the wiring in the third clip. Yay. Now to thread it through a hole in the heatsink and refit everything. Ah, this fan's sticking. Oh, I was poked back up through that hole. That's not a good hole without the extra cable to create a fold. Luckily there's space around the perimeter. If I were to do this again, I'd investigate getting a couple of 120mm fans and brackets for a PCI slot. 120mm fans are very impressive. These results are from a FurMark 720 preset that were published in my first teardown. I don't have the original records, just this graph. In future I'll keep the horizontal axis, each tick being 2.5 seconds. Next is a FurMark test with a 12cm case fan zip tied outside the shroud. There's an air gap of 20mm between fan and heatsink, and the fan is sitting on the bottom of my case. The only air intake it gets is from the metal grille offering a skirt of 2-3mm around the perimeter. Both these disadvantages mean it isn't a sustainable solution. Now, with the fans replaced, we have a reading from their tachometer, 60%. They shut off soon after testing as the GPU returns to its quiescent 40 degrees C. The difference with this 1080 preset FurMark is more memory and GPU load. It was begun 2 minutes after the 720p test finished.